So what we have here is a lithium-ion battery-powered guitar effects pedal power supply. So it's an isolated unit. It's all in one. We make the battery packs out of 18650 lithium-ion battery cells. We create our power system on top of that. And since it's an all-in-one unit, we have more control over the ins and outs of the battery pack, and we can get much more efficient step-up conversions and whatever else. So. And it's totally isolated. It's super convenient. You can just strap it to your pedal board, throw it on the ground, turn it on, and you're ready to play. So I've been playing guitar for a long time, and one thing that always frustrated me was when you're trying to get portable power within these units, you can throw a 9-volt battery in, but it only lasts maybe an hour or two. And so we wanted to find a way to have battery-powered effects units that last a lot longer and that are more reliable and rechargeable.
You know, we had our original concept, and you know, it took a little while. We got a breadboard trying things out. We had to figure out like what's gonna work, and what kind of values we're looking at, what's our peak, what's our low, and how are we gonna match what we need the output to be so that it's useful for everyday use, right? So we start designing these things, make a small circuit, and then go from there, really.
So what is your background? Are engineering, or what do you guys do?
I do computer science mostly. I like to work with a lot of the lower level electronics though, and I kind of dabble around with it. I'm more of a hobbyist, but I don't really have much formal training in it. But it's just something that's interested me. But I formally studied computer science.
And I'm an engineer by trade, but you know, I've always tinkered with stuff my whole life, really. I've always, electronics, computers, all that stuff has been like, you know, a passion of mine. So doing something like this is really fun for me, because it's just, you get to just go there and you get stuck in it for hours and you don't even realize it's passed, right? So
you're telling me these are just prototypes, correct?
Yes.
So what is the next step? What do you have to do to get this designed for manufacturing and ready to actually produce these in bulk?
Well, we still obviously have a lot more testing to do. We've got some different options that we're looking at in terms of what kind of, where we want to place everything, how many outputs we want to have on it, what kind of switches we want to use. I mean, it's endless, the amount of options we have to add on to this thing.
So what would you say has been the most interesting and exciting part of this project?
So, I mean, for me, it's been like the past 3 days just putting together these prototypes real quick, because, you know, I live further away from where he is, so we're kind of doing this thing remotely, and it's hard to do hardware when you're both not right there sitting next to each other the whole time. So, you know, for me, like the past few days have just been sink into it and get stuff done. And it's really rewarding, because, you know, you're pulling all-nighters, but you come out and you're like, hey, it works. Oh my God, it worked the first time, you know, and that's that aha moment. And, you know, just coming here and being able to show it off and be like, hey, I built that, you know, that's great.
And you said that aha moment, just, you feel fantastic. On the flip side, what has been the worst portion of doing this? What have you just banged your head against the wall? What has been the most challenging and interesting portion?
So some of the design work we've been doing, just like trying stuff out, and then we hit a wall and it doesn't work, right? And then you're like, oh, back to the drawing board. Or, you know, for me, when I'm tinkering around with the electronics and, oh crap, I fried something or whatever. And you're like, oh, now I got to go run back down to the store, and there goes another 4 hours.
Or accidentally shorting out a lithium ion battery. That's fun.
That's always fun. That's probably the most frustrating parts, but you know, there's ups and downs, but it's all fun at the end of the day.